And today it was about writing. So let me ask you as we wrap up today, this idea of, and you told me that you're now writing a yep. book. I have a plan to write
I'm working
a book.
On, I'm working on a couple things.
With a co-author, but also something on your own, I think.
Yeah, I've got a couple things I'm working on,
All right, so let me just ask, what's your process for sitting down? And we used the analogy earlier of the Chevy Chase with the word "the," and he never could get past that. What's your approach to it when you say, okay, I feel passionate about this topic or this is the idea, I want to write about it? Where do you start with that?
For me, it's only two things. It's okay. really a simple process, so it's not even a process. First, if I don't set a regular writing time, it doesn't happen.
Yes,
and it's
great.
Ideal to, if it's a priority, then it's got to be when it's a high energy time. So whatever works for you. When I was a younger writer, it was the middle of the night with a six pack of beer.
Right.
These days it's like days. 5 a.m, you know, and when I've still got any kind of energy left. That's the first thing. And the second thing, and it goes to your point about too many these, too many ands, too much ketchup stretcher in your, something I learned, I've had many incarnations, I think, as a writer and a wannabe writer. You know, I was the creative writer, I was an English major and all that, and then I became a wrote in administrator ease, and then, you know, I've done all kinds of different things. So we were talking about style guides. I've had all kinds of different style guides. But one of the things I learned in a creative writing course as an undergrad is write down all that stuff.
Yes.
Put it aside, then come back with a pencil and cross out about half of it.
Right. So that first impulse is to get it out there, but you need to come back to it later and make
Well, bro, you're just jamming. It's not really a solo. You take the jam and you craft it into a solo that'll
fit in. I love the music analogy.
It'll fit into a 3-minute deal that you can put on radio. You know, there's only so many people that want to go see a jam band, right?
Right, right.
And sometimes the jam's happening, sometimes it's not. Sometimes stream of consciousness is good, sometimes it's not. So.
That long guitar solo that the guitar thinks it's the best thing ever. Not sure the audience is appreciating it in that level all the time.
Yeah, well, the bass player's ready to pull a plug on a guy. You know, he's looking at the singer saying, kick that plug out of the wall wart. So, you know, he'll think his amp's broken. Or maybe he won't notice.
He won't notice. He's in his own world.
Yeah, but that whole idea, because there's two things. First, the first time out, you don't want to get in your own way by second guessing everything you're putting down. This is me now. It's not
everybody. No. That's a very good point, because that's the block right there, and you have to freeform it at the start. You have to just say, "Hey, we're not choosing the final draft here. We're brainstorming and throwing everything out there that comes to mind." Then you can go back and do something.
First be. Stay out of your own way and just lay something out, even if it's rotten.
Right.
And then second, later on when you come back to revise, be vicious and fierce.
Yeah, you got to cut it.
With the reader in mind. What are you trying to accomplish for the reader? If it's just, if you're just jamming, you know, you're entertaining yourself. You might as well be sitting there at midnight with a guitar and nobody hearing it, right?